Thanks for tuning in. You know, I want to talk a little bit with you about rewiring your brain. I have dedicated some videos about use of the language, use of the words you say to yourself, the so-called self-talk. And this is crucial, absolutely crucial. What are you saying to yourself? Because the words you say, your word is your wand, it says in the Bible. Now, I was not raised religiously, so honest, I have to admit that I have never read the Bible, just some passages that we had to read in school. You know, that's where it ends, and that's about, oh, I think 2 or 3 years, a little bit of that. But I was not raised in a certain religion. Yes, I was raised to believe that there is a something bigger than all of us. And for me, that is source. And some people call that God. And other people call it the universal knowledge. I use those words as well. But here's the thing. The law of attraction, and I can't help it, it's just one of the at least 12 laws that I know that are, you know, ruling this whole universe we live in. You know, the law of polarity, there's an up and a down, there's an in and an out. I just sort of forgot a little bit about it, but you can check them out. What are the 12 laws of the universe? And the law of attraction is, law of attraction or vibration, is the number one law. Everything is basically based on that law, meaning it's like a boomerang. When you give out, you get back. Very simple. So how do you rewire your brain? Well, as a child, you were fed a lot of information through your parents, your caregivers around you, and that may not have landed in the right way in you and caused you to feel rejected, feel not enough, and cause you to feel miserable. You know, like you never do anything right. Well, how does that make you feel? That's a form of rejection, you know, like you're not good enough. It's a form of rejection. So having heard words like that, and you don't remember what the words were, and that's okay. You want to change the language that you're feeding yourself. You want to rewire the pathways. Now, rewiring the brain is nothing new. It happens on a daily basis. Every day, every time you learn something new about anything, anything, you rewire the brain. You just, how can I say this better? What you have learned, and that is now obsolete because it has been overwritten by something updated, that is rewiring the brain. And we learn from, you know, automobiles and technology and this and that and everything, but we hardly ever learn how to rewire our brain. And it's not difficult. You just got to be willing to do it. And what it's based on is your look on life and your words that you're using, your self-talk, and stop beating yourself up. That's another thing. We all make mistakes. We're human. We're supposed to be learning from a mistake. When we make a mistake, we go like, okay, oops, and life goes on in the fast lane. If you haven't died, you just continue to go on and say like, that was just, yikes, I didn't really like that. You know, spend a minute on it and just move on. Move on. But what you say to yourself is usually based on what you have learned in your childhood, what the first words that you heard about you. I mean, you're not good enough. You're never going to amount to anything. Ask anybody. Yes, they have heard those words. That's okay. That usually was the frustration of a parent. And they needed to vent it, and they vented out to their children because they knew that their children could not do anything with it. I mean, children could rebel, but a four-year-old rebelling, where's that going to go? Nowhere, because the four-year-old, when it rebels and the mother shouts, I'm going to send you away. Yeah, the house going to, come on, let's just be adults about this. That's not going to work, right? And the four-year-old doesn't even know how to rebel. Yeah, it just throws a tantrum. That's a different ballgame. But logically calculated rebelling, no. That's what the child doesn't do. So you were fed a lot of words that probably didn't serve you that well. Check the statistics. 75% of everything that we have learned in our childhood is based on negativity. Yeah. It is what it is. But you can turn it around. Now that you know this, you can turn it around. Observe yourself. What are you saying to yourself? How do you look at yourself? When you look in the mirror, what do you see? I see a fantastic, gorgeous, slim, slender, wonderful, energetic woman, radiating love, radiating friendship, radiating everything. That's what I see. What do you see? You're beating yourself up now? Oh God, I'm ugly. My hair is ugly. My skin is ugly. I'm 50 pounds overweight and this and that. Huh? What is radiating out of your eyes? How are you as a person? Observe that. Write that down. And when you have your off moments, when you like to beat up on yourself, when you like to degrade yourself, as we so often do, just write down the emotions that is connected with it and write down what you're doing next. Are you grabbing the muffin, the cookies, the chips or whatever to suppress that feeling of misery? Because that is what keeps you stuck in losing weight. It's very simple. If you don't really appreciate yourself, love yourself, nothing really goes well. Don't say that, no, it's going fine for me and I'm 100 pound overweight and I'm blissfully happy. Yeah, really? 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 Huh, that would be interesting. You would be a first because, So rewiring the brain is replacing the negative things that you have heard and have learned as a habit to say to yourself to live by, forget about those, and create new empowering words, phrases. Applaud yourself, praise yourself. When you do something good, you say like, that was great, congratulations, proud of you. Just little things like that. You don't have to do it out loud. Just do it in your head. And if you can, just do it on your breath, under your breath. And if you like, just say it out loud. And if you feel even better, just shout it out. Why not? Who cares about the rest? It's a really good book. What You Think of Me is None of My Business. It was written by Dr. Terry Cole Whittaker. Really good book. Just applaud yourself, praise yourself. In that doing, you rewire your brain. The more you do, and in the beginning, you go like, this is weird. This is really weird. That's what I thought in the beginning. You got to be kidding me, really? But you know, do it over and over again. Just do at least, start once a day. And if you go like, ah, I did that, then do it twice a day. More and more and more until it's not something that you do. It's something who you are. It's the person you are. Just like when you wake up in the morning with or without an alarm, just say like, I love my life. I love this planet. I am so very happy. This is going to be a phenomenal day. I'm going to have fun no matter what. Before you even touch the floor with your feet. Just do that. Make it a habit. If you forget, just put a little piece of paper next on your headstand there, on your next to your bed, so you can remember. And that's again, you know, in the beginning, it's something to help you remember, and then it's a natural new fabulous habit. We got to positively rewire our brain because it's not only making us feel better. But here's the thing, when you feel better, your whole system, your whole body functions better. You become healthier. You become slimmer because you don't need to suppress all those negative feelings. So the power lies within you. Totally, totally, totally. You can take it or leave it. What do you want? Do you want to have a happy life? Do you want to have a smiling, happy presence when you go into the room? The people turn their heads and say, what are you so happy about? Or you're way too much happy. And you go like, yeah, I am. I'm very happy. I'm happy for no reason. It's not a good book from Marcy Shymoff. Happy for no reason. Great book. The happiest country is not in the United States. It's in Africa. So just, if you want to, you can look it up in the library or in the digital library. Fantastic book. So happiness is a choice. Happy is not something that somebody else gives to you. You know, when you marry me, I'll be happy. Or when I have that new car, I'll be happy. Or when we move into the new home, I'll be happy. Or when I have the new job, I'll be happy. Or when whatever. No. Make the decision to feel and be happy. And look how everything is going to flow in your life. It will. It does in mine. And I wasn't raised that way. Oh no, I wasn't raised that way. So give it a shot. Doesn't cost you a penny. And if your surroundings say like, what the hell are you doing? You can either ignore them or you can say, this is what I'm doing or have been doing for the past couple of weeks. I suggest you might do the same. Observe yourself and rewire your brain and get slimmer, get healthier, get happier. All right, that's it. The disclaimer, you know it. Everything I just told you is a compilation of whatever I have learned from all of my fabulous mentors. Put it in the magic mix. And just, or the Vitamix, it's here called in the United States. And just pour my special sauce over it. And that's what I present to you. If you like it, press the like button. Subscribe if you haven't done that yet already. Pass it on to anybody who you feel might benefit from my content. And if you don't like it, that's okay as well. I appreciate you anyway. So I wish you a fabulous remainder of the day. Take care now. Bye-bye.